return this back to sender. Was there a return address on this shit or no? Let's see. You've been on our mind. We have so much love for you. XO, Maj and the team. What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel. And today we are going to be unboxing Beautycon's, what should I call it? Redemption box? Before we get into all of this, this video is sponsored by Car Marshall. If you need a new car, a used car, or any car, Car Marshall will be there to negotiate for you. Go down in the description box and in the pinned comment down below to learn more. So if you do not know, a couple months ago, I did a video about Beautycon and how they basically Beautyconned everyone that was there and paid their hard-earned money to be there. If you did not watch that video, I'm going to link it down below or have it in the eye up above. To make a long story short, Beautycon NYC this year was absolute trash, okay? The samples are trash, the exhibits are trash, Cardi B showed up 5 hours late, the hauler bags were really garbage. So in order to make up for all of that, they sent out like another beauty package situation. So if you had went to Beautycon and you paid for a $200 hauler bag, or more, I'm not sure, general admission, got the same email. Basically, they sent out an email saying they were gonna send like more stuff and you're supposed to fill out like this Google form with your address, blase blase, and they sent you a new batch of shit, or I guess to make up for all the caca that they did. Honestly, it shit took forever. It's now June. Beautycon was in April. So, I mean, I don't know what took them so long. Also, apparently, Cardi B was supposed to be giving a gift. I don't know if this box is part of the gift or if there's something separate. I'm not sure how that works, but nonetheless, I'm definitely here for this motherfucking box. So I completely forgot about this box. That's how long it's been since I filled out a form to get my gift or whatever, right? So I ordered some food. I went downstairs. Let's go get it. I look at the floor and I see a FedEx package and I'm like, oh fuck, what did I order? And then I looked at the box. This is definitely the Beautycon situation, right? This is definitely what they do. Like, this looked like a Beautycon type of box. And I was like, oh shit, okay, this must be Beautycon, but I don't want to open it. So I peeked. I peeked in it. I saw the little, the paper. Had the Beautycon logo. I was like, alright, nope, I gotta film. I need to see what caca these people put in this box. Now, as you can see, it's already leaking. There's something in here fucking leaking. Now, I don't know why the fuck Beautycon thought it was okay to have FedEx deliver this box. FedEx is one of the worst fucking delivery services. Maybe they use FedEx to deliver all their stuff. I'm not even sure. But FedEx is trash. They throw their packages all over the place. I don't know if this happened at their facility, if this happened when FedEx threw that shit at my door. I don't know. But FedEx is trash. So whatever this is, I don't know, like, I hope it wasn't valuable because this is literally how the box came. Came in a little parcel and then the box was in a parcel and then I saw all of this shit. It looks like, oh, it smells really good. It's lotion, I think. Never mind, it don't smell that good. Or maybe it's the paper mix, I don't know. Before we get into the unboxing, there's a couple things I need to address from the last video. So there was a couple of people who decided to put their two cents into the situation, saying that those of us who were complaining about the hauler bags or complaining about the Beautycon experience should have been grateful for all the shit that we did get. Listen, bitch, if you did not pay the $200 or more to be at Beautycon, I don't want to hear your mouth. We're not there, you did not go there, you did not experience it. So just shut up and enjoy the fucking video. Also, I know a lot of you guys were sending me Lala's video. She did a whole recap of what happened and telling people what really happened at Beautycon. And she was also, to me, it seemed like she was invalidating people's experiences. And again, if you did not pay for it, if you did not have the experience of paying your hard-earned money to go to this event and be disappointed by extremely long lines, subpar samples, disrespectful security guards, and a Cardi B coming 5, 6, whatever, however many hours late, then I don't want to fucking hear it, okay? I don't understand why people who ever have anything to do with a situation, people who don't suffer from a situation, people who didn't go through a situation always want to put their mouth into shit. You didn't pay for shit. You got paid to be there. You were a host. I'm sure your hotel was paid for. Everything was paid for. You weren't on the floor. You weren't in the lines, you weren't getting samples, you weren't doing what we were doing. So I don't understand why you think think it's okay to put your two cents into saying such and such tried to make things better and this is what happened. No. As far as I'm concerned and as far as I know, Beautycon didn't even issue a public apology, okay? They just issued individual apologies through email and tried to act like this shit didn't happen in public. Meanwhile, everybody dragging them on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all types of shit, but they try to cover that shit up and act like they didn't have to give us no public apologies, okay? Never got a public apology, never seen anything on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, anything like that. And I was like, oh, guys, we're very sorry that some of you guys got cursed out by some security guards that we hired. I'm very sorry that the hauler bags are trash. If anything, they were making excuses for a lot of the shit that they did. It was more so of a, we're sorry, here's a new box, shut up now. That's basically what it was. And whoever else was defending them should have never made these videos defending them. What they did was wrong. They hired subpar staff. They had mediocre fucking brands there with mediocre fucking samples. It was just a terrible experience and they need to own up to it. Like, not just hush hush behind closed doors, throw a box together and ship it to our motherfucking houses and expect us to be hee hee ha ha happy. Like, no, I'm not giving Beautycon my money ever again. If you ever see me at Beautycon, just know someone paid me to be there. Okay? Someone paid me to be there. I did not pay my own goddamn money to be there. I'm not supporting this brand. They're full of shit. They don't care about their customers. And this experience just proves it. And I'm done supporting people who don't support me. Okay? I'm over it. There wasn't enough black brands there in the first place. So, I mean, it's whatever. Only the people who spent their money on this trip, okay, spent their money at this convention can understand the amount of frustration that we went through. If you was a VIP, if you was flown out, if you didn't pay for shit, then I don't want to hear you talk about some, oh, we're ungrateful and we doing too much. You should be held accountable for the actions, point blank fucking period. So, let's get straight into this unboxing. It's just, so we're gonna get to opening this. So, okay. It has some weight to it though, for a little box. Oh, this is cute. Okay, this is really cute. Okay, mascara. Okay, Rimmel London mascara. All right, we got you. Press on nails, okay. I don't use these types of things, so I'm gonna have to give this away. What is this, a pen? This is very cute, I'd actually wear this. It's a little pen, it's from something I can't read. I don't know what that says. Laser kitten. They got something from Purelease, whatever. I think this is Asia. It says beauty through Asian wisdom. Maybe this is like some sort of lotion. Okay, this is cute. Blue Lotus Balancing Moisturizer Hydration Fine Line Prevention, perfect for under makeup. So I guess this is kind of like a face lotion slash primer situation. This is really cute. Ooh, I got one of these. This is a jewel. I'm not sure. They gave me a lipstick at Beautycon and I actually really liked it. It's like this purpley color. I wonder what color this is. Oh, it's not a color. I think it's just a lip balm. I'm very sad. It says essential lip enhancer conditioning lip treatment. That's let me put some on my skin, on my little thumb. Oh, it's all like illuminating. I don't think y'all can see that. Y'all can't see that. It doesn't smell like anything, but it's like it's more of a gloss. It has like a little tint to it. I don't know. Oh, okay. I'll use this at night. Hydrate my lips or whatever. You feel me? Oh, well, this is what spilled, apparently. And it was... Bruh, this shit slippery. What the... Oh, this shit got on my hair. What is this? What is it? It is leave-in detangling. Oh, that's good for the hair. It's for wigs, too. It's from Wig Out. This shit busted. And I don't think that was part of the package. I don't think FedEx did that, y'all. I think this was just already fucked up. Cause this shit is like half empty, y'all. Half empty. Y'all, I don't know if y'all can see that. I don't think y'all can see that. It's half empty, though. Well, that's not good. I need to clean this up. This is not cute. Oof, I never knew they sold like wig detanglers. I just used water or like regular conditioner. Lashes, definitely giving these away because I don't do lashes. I've never put on lashes ever in my life. Okay, they gave us some brushes. Okay, redemption. Okay, these are from Luxie. Oh, I needed some new brushes. All right, now y'all know I don't wear makeup like that, so I don't know what any of these brushes are for, but they're cute. This look like a fountain. foundation. Do these things say? Okay. Large angle. Thank God they have something on them. They have the names of the stuff. A tapered highlighter. And then we got a duo fiber powder brush. I don't know. Let me take out one of these. I want to feel it. Wow, it feels so nice. Oh. Okay. They did a nice job. Why couldn't y'all do this right the first time? Okay. I fucks with it. Okay, bitch. I don't even use brushes, though. I only use brushes for my eyes. I use a beauty blender for my face. The only time I ever use a brush is, like I said, for my eyes and also for, what's that thing called? Highlighter and stuff. So, we'll see if I actually use that. We have this from Maybelline. It is a Color Central Shaping Lip Liner. I don't know what color this is. It says 120 Rich Chocolate. I don't use lip liners, though. I've never really used one. Okay. Dermal Blend Professional Loose Setting Powder. Yes, y'all. Y'all know I be using baby powder all the time. Now I got some... How the hell is this open? Now I got some setting powder. I feel rich now, y'all. I can stop using the baby powder that's gonna cause me cervical cancer on my face, you know? How do you open this shit? It's not opening. I feel like this is gonna be a disaster if I keep tampering with it. So maybe I should stop tampering with it. Oh, wow, I'm stupid as fuck, y'all. It's just the sticker on the inside I had to remove. Actually, I'm not gonna remove it now, but I guess there's holes and then y'all get the point. I needed one of these. Well, actually give me shit I actually needed. Artist Couture, I guess this is a bronzer. It says Diamond Glow Powder, okay. I guess it could be used as a bronzer too. Okay. I need some glow powder. I don't think I have any glow powder like this, like loose powder. Oh wow, Milani. I think this is an eyeshadow, I would assume. Bella Cappuccino, okay. I'm not gonna open this because I'm not gonna use this anytime soon. I have too many colors that look like this, but this is Milani, so I feel like I'm going somewhere special. The Brow Gal by Tanya Crooks. Never heard of this. Double-ended shimmer matte highlighter pencil. Oh god, this thing is wet from the thing. It's like, oh god, this is nasty. I need to take this out the box ASAP. Throw the box out. Could somebody explain this to me? Why would I do my brows? This must have been for the white girls, because I don't understand what I'm supposed to do with this. How am I supposed to do my brows with this? I guess I could use this for some, but it says highlighter pencil. Maybe I could use this like on my eye thing. What's that thing? That thing. Okay, I'm confused, so I'm just gonna put that down. All right, so next we got something from the Brow Gal. Again, and this is like a spoolie. And the other end, I'm not sure. Let me open this. I just took the damn, y'all, this shit is just not working out. All right, the other side, so this is like a little brush. So you could do a little liner with that. And then the other end is just a spoolie. Huh. This is very cute. I actually really like this. Constructed pretty damn well. Very damn shit. What material is this? This shit. Serious. Next we got this Timeless Serum. I have no idea what Matrixyl is. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. Contains water, Matrixyl 3000, aloe, something I can't say, glycerin, hyaluronic acid, benzyl alcohol, dehalala, something I can't pronounce. A whole bunch of stuff. I guess this is for your face. This just sounds like something for your face, right? I'm gonna have to Google this. I don't know what this is, but this look expensive. Sound expensive too. Okay. We got the Simple Sensitive Skin Cleansing Facial Wipes. These are not that bad. I don't love them though. They're okay. Something from When Mini Spa by Skin Intelligence, innovative skincare brand. What is the point of this? It just tells me why When was created. Is there a gift card in this shit or something? What is the point of this card? Ooh, it's hot in here though. I ain't got my AC on. All these lights. It's hot in here. But I don't see the point of this. There's nothing in here. It's just telling me about the damn company, and I don't really care too much for the company, so. Waste of space. Another card, Moisture Milk, $40. let's see, a blessing of water for every skin, relieving dryness with a gentle touch. This is just, first of all, again, with these tiny ass samples, what the fuck am I supposed to do with this? Okay, y'all should have learned not to put no more damn packets in these goddamn boxes. Beauty and the breast. Biocellulose skin sheet. Wait, what? I'm supposed to put this on my breast, y'all? Wait, contains two masks. Wait. Oops. Okay. Anyhow, contains one mask. Okay, so I'm supposed to put these on my boobs. Why would I put mask on my boobs? People just come up with everything. What the hell? Look at this. I'm supposed to like... Okay. I don't really see the point of this, honestly, but maybe I'll just try it one day. That was pretty damn useless. Oh, we got a fucking palette. And you know what's really funny? I already have this palette. It's from Rimmel. I think this is the same exact palette I got last year. How amazing. I might have to check if it's the same exact one. I feel like this one probably has darker colors, but I know I do have a Rimmel London palette just like this that I got from BeautyCon last year. Oh, finally, a lippy. We got bold lip color from... I cannot read this. What the fuck does this say? This font is weird as fuck. I cannot read this damn font, y'all. What is that? I don't know, but this, yo, guys, the box has a whole bunch of the leave-in detangler all over the place. Oh, this is nice. I hope it's a red. I needed a red. Oh, it's a pink. I'll take that. Let's see. Oh, this shit creamy. That shit came on effortless. I don't know the name of the damn company. I can't fucking pronounce this shit because I can't. What the hell does this say? Damn, I can't read. That's sad. They need to take my damn bachelor's back. Yo, I love this color, y'all. Look how pretty it is. I can't wait. Oh my god, this I can't wait to wear. Another wind mask, youth recharger for neck. What the fuck, a neck mask? Oh, what the hell's the point of all these goddamn masks? Okay, I'm good. I got so many damn masks from BeautyCon from last year. This year is just so annoying. Like, I don't really do masks like that. I have my own little routine and I stick to it. I try not to put masks on my face. And this is another one. This is a, premium biocellulose sheet mask firming. We need a fabulous base for flawless skin, blah 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 blah, for all skin types. Oh, okay, this is interesting. So they gave three masks. Oh shit. And then this is fresh moisturizing soothing gel, organic complex and cooling soother, dermatologist tested. I don't know what this is. Is this a lotion? Is it a shower gel? Is it candy? Like, I don't know what this is. And then there's another pin. Oh, this is cute. BeautyCon BFF. Alright. This is cute. I give this to y'all. This is pretty adorable. I'm never gonna wear it because I'm not supporting the shit no more, but super cute. Okay. And that's it. And then in the box, it just says BeautyCon box. Oh, hey, beauty. Why are you reading this? Unbox me already. Cute. Nice marketing. I think they could just return this back to sender. Was there a return address on this shit or no? I'm not really impressed. It was all right. It wasn't terrible. I was kind of excited about a lot of the stuff though. It wasn't terrible. Some of the stuff was really good. Can't get my time back. So there's that. But okay, do I think this was worth a redemption? It's okay. It's not terrible. Yeah, I did alright. I don't hate it. It's cute. Best thing here was the brushes, to be completely honest. And the Milani eyeshadow was alright. Oh, and I think the translucent powder as well as this Artist Couture bronze powder is pretty good. But other than that, everything was just very subpar. I don't see anything special about anything that they gave us. It's all right. I don't know. Let me know what y'all think about what they gave us to redeem those awful hauler bags that they gave us. But it was all right. I just don't see that special about it. Let me know, will you be going to BeautyCon next year? Which one? LA, New York? Did my experience haunt you? Like, let me know, like, are y'all going, are y'all not? Because honestly, unless they pay me or someone pays me to go, I'm not spending my money on that shit ever again because they really pissed me the fuck off. Let me know what you think about this video down in the comment section below. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'ma see y'all next time.